I'm back. My cats. I painted one of those. The one that looks weird, like a bug. You see it? Yep. I don't know if I put them on camera before. Those are not my real cats. My real cats are real cats. They move around all nimbly bimbly like. They meow. Not now. Damn it, I can never say meow instead of now when I think about it. Meow now. Didn't watch Big Brother because the meow meow got second. I just finished Big Brother. That's 2 weeks late, I think. We're still getting fucking election ads. I guess technically the election's still going on, even though the margin of victory is not in doubt in almost any state. And when you talk about Bush v. Gore, I believe that was, you know, hundreds of votes, not tens of thousands of votes. Biden got 300 plus Electoral College votes. Electoral College should still be abolished because it's bullshit. Regardless, you are not here to talk about my political views. You don't need to really know them. I think you probably know them. Anyway, I have this many PWEs. It'd be nice if there were checks in them as well. Like, it feels like, do you remember, I guess if you're my age, which is pushing 40, you used to get mail like that from your grandparents, aunts, uncles, whatnots. Mostly just my grandparents. My aunts and uncles are pretty terrible people. Not my one uncle, who I like a lot, and not my other aunts, whose children might see this because they follow me on Facebook. And now I'm just envisioning the next 3 days of my mom's calls to me. And is it worth it to go back? I mean, this is a minute and 42 seconds of solid gold content. Yeah, let's push forward. Anyway, these usually portended that you got like $5 for Easter from your granny. Maybe $10 for your first communion from Auntie so-and-so who drives a Studebaker. You know what I'm talking about. Now I just get random mail that tries to get me to sign up for State Farm. That's pretty much most of my mail. And retirement accounts that have very little amount of money and legal shit. Anyway, I also got this. It's from FedEx. Well, it's not from FedEx. It's from 718 Films on Twitter. He is a great dude. You should check out any kind of content he produces is really good. I would say it's much better than this in what you're seeing, but I don't want to drive my viewers away. But I probably just said that out loud, didn't I? I have too much Who on my iPod. Who? The Who, the band. A little bit of hype music. We got from 24/7 Sports Cars. We got a sweet bass. Sweet bass. Randall Cunningham. Look at that. Is that a printer mark? No. I can't even tell what a printer mark is anymore. Kelly Rowan. Hella underrated, by the way, right? We all can agree on that. Like, she has some fucking bangers that really... She was good on that show, that fashion show with, I think, Isaac Mercer. Ha! That's not too... Playing in the background. That's Shock Linwood. It's out of 99. It's purple. It's hot to death. It's supposed to rain tomorrow. I intend to spend a lot of time updating my displays of the Shock Linwood, the Corey Clements. I think I'm going to have to switch out a display box because I've gotten so much stuff from the baseball cards, which you've seen. And there's just some things that I'd like out and some things that I don't care that much about. And some of those things I want to sell because I need some money. This is... I'm not sure. But I go deeper. Can't find us keepers. Oh shit, I forgot about these. The sweet and low. These are very important to me. Two Stadium Cup cards that were really hard to find that I made a nice little trade for. Pretty stoked to have these. And I'm close to finishing my Stadium Cup. One other reason I am in this location is that I mailed stuff here by accident. My binder. I bought a binder and pages to put the Stadium Club in a binder because I want to flip through it. Like you want to rub your hand through my hair right now. That's how I want to do in my stadium club. That's what I want to do. That's what I want. That's what I want to do. What we got? This is this is not a baseball card. Huh. This is a thank you from the African American Teaching Fellows, which is a amazing organization in the Charlottesville area, not Charlottesville era. I don't know what the Charlottesville era was, but I imagine there were a lot of petticoats. Charlottesville area that helps and support black people getting into teaching, which is very important. We need more teachers in general. We need just so many more, but we need more teachers that represent our population as well, that have that kind of learned experience that I certainly do not have. But this is just a thank you. It's a great charity. I highly encourage you to look them up. They do fantastic work. If just their website's great, you'll see the impact and how important that impact is to just hundreds of thousands of people in that area, but also if they can prove that model, just how it will go kind of nationwide. And I'm happy to give them a monthly donation. Also, pro tip, monthly donations to charities, big effing deal. When they can rely on income coming in, they can plan a lot better than waiting for your $100 at the end of the year. It'd be much better for you to do like $12 a month. Well, I know it's more money. $10 a month than $100 at the end of the year. It's obviously more money as well. I can't divide 100 by 12. It's 8.5. I don't fucking know. But donate monthly is what I'm saying. And then maybe I will send you a Ryan Grant rookie card, Tulane University. These are cool cards. I really like them. This is like my third. This dude keeps putting them on eBay, starting them at 1 cent with no shipping. And I think I got this one for 54 cents, I think. All day on that guy. Pretty sweet. And now we get to the position. I mean, it's worth more than the fucking card saver comes in. It's worth more than 50 cents, I think. I don't know. This is Pat Green. He has COVID. Why do I make that like a joke? It's not a joke that people are getting COVID at all. I don't want you to think that I think that. But he did have, like, he's been doing some I like Pat Green. He's probably the musician I've seen more than any other musician. He's opened my eyes to a lot of different types of music, although it's mostly red dirt country music, the Wade Bowens, Josh Abbott's, Randy Rogers Band, Cross Canadian Ragweed, Cory Morrow, Robert Earl Keen, et cetera, Steve Earle. I like it. I don't know. I like the storytelling. It's rollicking. It's something I feel like I've heard. Listened to a lot of CCR growing up. A lot of Neil Young, Skynyrd. Anyway, I forget. There was a point here. Oh, it's that we are bad at COVID. Because I think I saw that 3 SEC games are postponed to this weekend. I mean, numbers are staggeringly bad. It's terrifying, really. But you know what? At least we have friends on the internet and friends in real life. I don't know. Maybe you have real friends that don't live in Canada and aren't as sexy as my friends that live in Canada that send you things like this that you thought you'd be able to open because you're a strong man with dexterous fingers and within reach of a scissor. It's not happening. We're going to have to pause it. Pause. Is it paused? Can't tell if it's paused or not. Blink once if it's paused. It's not paused. Okay. Blink twice if it's paused. I blinked a lot. Does that mean it's back? It's ring. Oh, there's a dial at the bottom. This is Carry On by Pat Green. It is, I believe, one of the best red dirt country music songs of all time. I would say possibly the best. We're going to listen to it again while I try to open this. Because I feel like I flubbed that for you. And like the levels, man, we got to get on the right level. This is great. Did I show? Look at that. To my Orioles fan. That's me. Of course, to me. From Big Dave. This is exciting. I am pumped. I'm telling you, man, if you can get... I've spent the last... Well, I guess it's been 8 months of COVID. But I've spent the last 8 months trying to... Not on purpose, really. Just makes me feel good. Just give cards away. I don't need a lot of the cards I have. I don't collect the Astros or the Yankees. Who would collect the Yankees? I mean, everyone collects the Yankees. Ugh, bastards. Why couldn't I have been born a Yankee fan, right? But like, I've met and have so many now just consistent trading partners. And calling them trading partners is like not even accurate, like, because I'll send them something, months later they'll send me something, I'll send another thing. It's when I accumulate stuff, like when I get my Astros in, that's going to Jose and Ryan. When I get my Nationals, it's going to Chris. When I get my Cubs, it's going to Zach. When I get my Keston Harris, Yusei Kikuchi's, my Yankees, goes to Adam. My other Yankees go to Dave. My other Yankees go to 718. There's a lot of Yankees. When I get Giants cards, I can get rid of them. Adam likes the Wolverines. Pat likes the Blue Jays, and Josh likes the Twins, and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. There's dudes that love the Braves, love Oregon State, collect this and that. And you find the people that will return the favor in kind, and then you just pay it for, you're not paying it forward, you're paying it back and forth. It's just implicit trading. When I send you something, I'm sending it because I know you'll like it. I don't need anything back, but I know that you're the type of person that would send something back just because that's who you are, and that's how we've forged this in 8 months. So this is like the coolest thing I've ever seen. And like, doing a reveal off camera, pro tip, is what you should do. I don't know what all these YouTubers are doing with like, oh, let's focus on the cards and not the person. You guys are not narcissistic. Oh man, this is like, I don't even know. Shoti there before. Let us go. Okay. All right. This is, I'm speechless. Never even heard of such a thing before. I am being so delicate, and if you know me, I get impatient with things. I'm usually a bit of a bull in a china shop. Like that Night Court guy. You ever watch Night Court? I digress. John Larroquette. How can I always remember that guy's name? I don't know. He was the defense attorney, right? And they made him look like an asshole. Doing God's work, man. Find yourself some good friends. Bring them on back home. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh man, this is like fitting perfectly in with my idea to redo one of my cases into yet another Orioles case. Because this will provide such a... Number one of a three-issue series. Brooks Robinson. We're gonna open that guy. It's factory sealed. Well, that's gonna present a conundrum. Oh, so Frank Thomas, see? I believe that's the Frank Thomas they mean. Look at that Brooks Robinson fucking card on the back. I've never seen this before in my life. It's from 92, so that's not as old as I would have thought. It looks vintage as fuck. This is baller, yo. Oh, the exciting life story of one of the greatest baseball heroes. Who do we think that is? I don't know. Do we shake your booty? So yeah, I'm probably going to have to crack this open, which I'm going to like Google around and see. Plus, I need more video content because I'm running out of things. Although I did buy something ridiculous from China the other day. That's weird when you say those words together out loud. Anyway, long story short, find some people, trade with them, give things to them, you'll feel better, it'll come back to you. This is just great. I'm stoked. Maybe the real friends were the friends you met along the way? I don't remember. There's that line, right? The real lesson were the friends, I don't know, the real reward? This is great. Look how happy Brooks Robinson is. He's from Southern California, I think. No? No, that's Jim Palmer. I can't do the smile. That look a good smile? I don't know. I brush my teeth. You should brush your teeth too, children. I don't think children watch this. I hope they fucking don't. Jesus Christ. Oh, my God. Thanks, Big Dave. Thanks to everyone who sent me these things. Can't forget the Shock Limwood. The pretty fucking sweet mosaic. Randall Cunningham. Ugh. Have a good one, y'all.